Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics, guys. Today a quick video on Hyundai Elantra. This Elantra right here, guys, in the middle of driving after we filled it up, it started dying. It was misfiring. It was misfiring terribly bad. We couldn't get to highway speed at all, and all of a sudden, in the middle of the intersection, that thing died on us. I was like, it feels like it's running out of gas, but we just filled it up like 10 miles ago. I couldn't believe it, that was happening. Newer car, lower mileage, but what happened, guys? Okay, we connected the scanner, we had engine light on, and we had all these codes stored. So I'm gonna turn the scanner and show you. Okay, they're still stored in the memory of the car. I just want to demonstrate you quick and show you what the solution is and how we fix that in just a few minutes and a few dollars. Okay, I was so mad about it, but it was something simple. So let me show you now. We're going to connect to the car computer quick, read the codes, and see what else could be, okay, and how we solve the problem. Okay, you can see we have four codes stored. Okay, we're going to go ahead and read them now. Stored codes right there. So we have cylinder number 4 misfire, cylinder number 1 misfire, cylinder 2. Okay, you can see random misfires again, 4, 1, 2, multiple misfires. It's just crazy, guys. It's like the car was falling apart and it didn't want to start, so we had to push it and then it started again. And I tested the fuel pump really quick, pressure was good. Didn't have a gauge at the time, but obviously it did have enough pressure for the fuel to run. So I was like, it could be something else. Check spark plugs, everything's fine there, and it's just unbelievable that 3 out of 4 spark plugs will go bad all at the same time. That's like winning the lottery there. So we thought we had water in the gas, and we got one of those additives. But before we put it, we removed, okay, let me show you quick, we removed the fuel rail. Okay, it was super easy. It had only 2 nuts on this car, and removed the fuel rail, and we found out that the whole rail inside was full of water instead of gas. Okay, let me show you right here how easy it is. It has only 2 bolts, and all that was full of water. So the injectors weren't getting any gas, they were getting water. So my guess is when we got to the gas station, what happened? We got a bad gas with water, and 10 minutes later the car started dying. We put one of those bottles, guys. You can see gas line, antifreeze, and water remover. And less than 10 miles down the road, the car was running like brand new again. Okay, you can see this treats up to 20 gallons. We have 12.8 gallon fuel tank. It was full all the way. So we put the whole bottle in it. We drove it, guys, and ever since then, we haven't had a problem. We removed the fuel rail and we didn't have any water in it after that. So it worked pretty good. Something that we want to share with you guys, so we know what to expect. So always use it once in a while. We will recommend to do that so you don't get yourself in trouble. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.